我们祷告。
Let's pray.
天父上帝，我们感谢你。
Heavenly Father, we thank you.
你是爱我们的。
You love us.
你赐下你的话语给我们。
You give us your words.
让我们明白你的心意。
So that we understand your will.
也明白我们该做的事。
So that we understand what we should do.
请你打开我们每一个人的耳朵。
Open our ears.
愿你的话能够进入到我们的心里面。
Speak to our hearts.
我们祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
Amen. 上个星期我们看到父母偏心。
Last week we looked at parents' favoritism.
以扫和雅各他们自己也做错决定。
And Esau and Jacob also made their own decisions.
所以导致整个家庭破裂。
That all led to the brokenness of one family.
以扫放言要杀雅各。
Esau threatened to kill Jacob.
母亲就叫雅各暂时逃到舅舅拉班那里去。
And the mother told him to run away to his uncle Laban.
就在他逃亡的路上。
On his escape.
他不是遇到野兽。
He didn't run into wild animals.
他也没有遇到坏人。
He didn't run into any bad guys.
他遇到了上帝。
But he ran into God.
盼望今天我们每一位也能够遇见上帝。
It's also my hope that every one of us here will run into God today.
首先我们来看雅各他走到人生的低谷。
First, we are going to see how Jacob walked to the valley of life.
经文第十节讲到雅各他出了别是巴向哈兰走去。
In Genesis 28 verse 10, it says that Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran.
你们知道从哈别是巴到哈兰有多远吗？
You know how far it is between Beersheba and Haran?
给你们看一下地图。
Yeah,
猜猜看大概多远。
So this is the map. Can you guess how far it is?
三四百 km.
300-400 km?
啊？KL 去 Johor, okay,
KL to Johor,
300多 km,
about 300 km.
其实这个距离差不多是从新山到伯利士。
Well, the distance is about the same as from Johor Bahru to Perlis.
所以至少有800公里以上。
It's at least 800 km.
所以你想象一下，当时交通不方便呢。
So can you imagine back in those days, the transport system was There was no transport system.
当时没有飞机。
No airplanes.
没有火车。
No trains.
没有汽车。
No cars.
没有摩托。
No motorbike.
也没有脚车。
No bicycles.
他们是骑着骆驼或者驴一步一步走的。
They went on their journey with a camel or a donkey, step by step.
而经文提到雅各他没有什么交通工具。
And here in the passage, it tells us that Jacob had no transportation at all.
他说他当年只是拿着一根杖就出去了。
It says that he only went out with a stick.
因为逃命嘛。
You know, because he was running away.
所以对雅各来说，这个是非常遥远的距离。
He was running away for his life, and it was a great distance.
是一个非常陌生的距离。
It was a very strange distance.
也是一个非常艰难的路程。
And also a tough journey.
因为他从来没有去过这个地方。
He never been to that place.
即使是他亲戚，是他舅舅，他也没有见过他们了。
Even though Laban was his uncle, he never met him before.
雅各他也没有独自一个人去到那么远的地方。
He never been on a journey this far all by himself.
所以他不知道前面有什么危险。
So he didn't know any danger ahead of him.
不知道会不会被野兽吃掉。
He wasn't sure if he'll be eaten up by any wild creatures.
不知道前面会不会遇到坏人。
He didn't know whether or not he will run into any bad guys.
他真的不知道他是否能够顺利去到舅舅那里。
He didn't even know whether or not he'll make it to his uncle's place safely.
而且他现在是逃命，而不是去舅舅家玩哦。
And remember, he is now running away for his life. He's not going to have a sleepover at his uncle's place.
所以不知道他去到舅舅那里，他可以做什么东西。
He didn't know what he could do at his uncle's place.
所以他通通都不知道啊。
He didn't know anything. He knew nothing.
生命充满许多不确定性。
His life was full of uncertainties.
总的来说，他的前路一片迷茫。
In short, his His future was just a blur.
可以说他是走到人生的低谷了。
You can say that he was in the very, very, very valley of his life.
所以他到了一个地方，因为太阳落了，就在那里住宿，便拾起那地方的一块石头，枕在头下，在那里躺卧睡了。
So when he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep.
去哈兰的路上，基本上一路上都是旷野。
On the way to Haran, it was simply wilderness.
基本上是没有人居住的。
Nobody lived there.
也不会有房子给他住。
Let alone any accommodation for him.
所以他拾起了一块石头，就靠着睡在那里。
And so he just picked up a stone and rest upon it.
如果是你，这样子的一个情况。你有什么感触?
How would you feel if you're Jacob?
我想当时雅各他一定心里很深的一个感触。
I'm guessing Jacob must have been feeling very deeply.
为什么我会搞成那样?
What have I done to deserve this?
为什么我的人生会变成这样?
Why did my life become like this?
原本过得好好的哦。
I had a...Good life.
每天在家悠哉悠闲。
I was just chilling at home every day.
啊，不然就举反宅。
I could cook this and that.
啊，做自己喜欢做的东西。
I could do this and that I enjoy.
然后还是妈妈的心肝宝贝。
And I was a mommy's boy.
啊，还以为骗取了哥哥的这个名分。
I thought I deceived my brother for his blessings.
啊，自己就可以得到这些产业还有祝福了。
And I should have been blessed greatly.
结果现在要一个人孤单的逃跑。
And yet now I'm running away on my own.
什么都没有了。
I have nothing.
还要睡在石头上。
And yet I have to sleep on this rock.
点解会搞成咁呢?
Why on earth?
今年2月6号凌晨4点多。
Well, the 6th of February this year, it was about...4 o'clock in the morning.
大多数人都在睡梦中。
A lot of people were still sleeping.
突然土耳其、叙利亚边境发生了7.8级的地震。
And all of a sudden, the border between Syria and Turkey had a massive earthquake.
许多人可能还没有反应过来就已经被埋在废墟里面了。
Countless people were buried alive before they could react.
这是土耳其近100年来最严重的地震。
It was the worst earthquake for Turkey in recent 100 years.
现在死亡的人数还是一直在上升，已经到4万多人了。
The death toll is still rising, and there are about 40,000 deaths so far.
十多万人受伤。
More than 100,000 injuries.
许多建筑物倒塌。
A lot of buildings collapsed.
许多人一夜间失去了亲人。
Many people lost their families overnight.
一夜间失去了房子。
They lost their houses overnight.
失去了产业。
They lost their property overnight.
可以想象一下，如果是你的话。
Can you imagine if you were one of them?
一夜间十几万，可能百万，你的房子突然倒塌了。
You've lost your house and hundreds of millions others.
里面全部家具全都没有了。
No more furniture left.
车子压坏了。
Your car was broken.
保险没有的 claim.
No insurance.
家人也埋在里面走了。
You lost your families.
你会怎么办?
What would you do?
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
我相信我们每一个人都会走到人生的低谷。
I'm pretty sure that every one of us will somehow come to the valley of our life.
我不知道你经历你人生中最悲惨的一次是怎样的。
I'm not sure how your worst experience of life was like.
可能已经过去了。
It may have been past.
可能还在经历当中。
You may be still experiencing it.
可能你没有比雅各严重。
Maybe you are not as bad as Jacob.
你可能你比地震的灾民严重。
Maybe what you experienced was worse than the earthquake victims.
但是不管怎样
，No matter what，
人的尽头就是上帝的起头。
The end of man is the beginning of God.
这时刻，上帝就来找雅各了。
At this moment, God came to Jacob.
上帝要介入在雅各的人生里面。
God wanted to intervene Jacob's life.
哇，你可以看到身心疲惫的雅各，他竟然在石头上可以睡得着了。
You can see how tired Jacob was. He could even sleep upon this rock.
如果你今天要试一下，你可以去找一块石头，你试一下。
You can try this yourself. You can find a rock and see if you can sleep on it.
在石头上都可以睡得着，就表示他真的是很累了。
You can imagine how tired, how exhausted Jacob was. He was able to sleep upon this, even a rock.
所以雅各睡着过，他发了一个梦。
When he was asleep, he dreamt this.
他梦见一个梯子立在地上，梯子的头顶着天，有神的使者在梯子上上去下来。
He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it.
所以那个梯子也就是台阶了。
Yes, this ladder was the stairways.
我们看见他看见天使在那个从天上一直走上走下，走上走下，就透过那个台阶。
Yes, Jacob saw the angels walking up and down.The stairway.
然后他也看到上帝也在那个台阶上面。
He also saw that God standing there.
哦，上帝就对他说了一些话。
And God was speaking to him.
而这是上帝的应许，对雅各来说现在是非常重要的。
And what God had promised Jacob then was super important.
因为他逃命已经逃得很累很辛苦了。
Because he was running away so tiredly.
他对他的前面。完全没有任何的概念。
He had no idea whatsoever about his future.
不知道会不会顺利去到舅舅家，也不知道去到舅舅家会做什么。
He wasn't sure if he was going to make it to his uncle's place safely. He wasn't sure either what he was going to do at his uncle's place.
然而上帝说要将雅各他现在躺卧的地方赐给他和他的后裔。
And yet God promised Jacob thatWhere he was lying would be a place for him and his descendants.
所以就表示，我不会死在旷野了，雅各。
So it means to Jacob that he's not going to die in the wilderness.
我的人生也没有走到绝路了。
My life is not going to end here.
而且我还会走出黑暗。
I'm going to get out of this darkness.
走出困境和迷茫。
I'm going to get out of this troubles and...Confusion.
我一定有美好的明天。
I'm gonna have a bright future.
因为上帝说还会结婚，然后生子。
Because God mentions about my marriage, my descendants.
然后他的后裔还要像地上的尘沙那样多。
And his offspring is going to be as much as the dust of earth.
像东南西北扩散出去。
It's going to be spread all through.The different directions.
地上的万族都因你的后裔得福。
And the offsprings, all the people in the earth shall be blessed because of his offsprings.
不但如此，上帝还应许雅各会与他同在。
And not only that, God also promised to be with Jacob.
就是无论去到哪里，上帝都保护他。
It means wherever Jacob goes, God is going to be with him.
总不离弃他。
He will never be forsaken.
还没有完哦，最后一句才是最重要的。
It's not only that, but look at the last verse.
所有的这些应许，直到我成全了向你所应许的。
It says that I will not leave you until I've done what I've promised.
所以表示上帝一直与雅各同在，直到他兑现了所有他给雅各的承诺。
It means that God is going to...Stick with Jacob until he fulfills what he's promised.
所以上帝绝不会开一个空头支票给雅各。
God was not going to give Jacob a rubber check.
他说到必定会做到。
He's going to fulfill what he's promised Jacob.
哇，这是多么美好、多么盼望的一件事。
What a wonderful promise.
一般上小孩子他们看见父母离开他的时候，他们都会哭闹啊，对吗？
You know, a lot of kids, they cry and, you know, throw their temper when they see their parents leaving them.
所以每次我们可以看到幼儿园开学或者小学一年级开学的时候，哇，都是吵吵闹闹，那小朋友都是在哭，要妈妈，要爸爸。
Yeah, so you can see, you know, on the first day of kindergarten, the first day of year one in primary school, a lot of kids are crying because their parents are leaving them.
然后 AJ 每次看到我跟师母一离开房间嘛，也是在那边哭。
Every time AJ sees that my wife and I leave the house, I mean leave the room, he starts crying.
孩子看见父母离开会哭是正常的。
You know, it's very, very normal for kids to cry when they see their parents leaving.
因为父母是孩子的安全感。
Because parents are their security.
当他们发现，哎，父母要离开的时候，也意味着他的安全感离开了啊。
Their sense of security is gone with their parents when they leave.
所以他会害怕。
So they feel scared.
所以他就哭。
And they cry.
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
在我们的人生中。
In our lives.
我们最应该要害怕的就是上帝离弃我们。
What we should afraid the most is God's departure.
当我们的人生一帆繁风顺的时候，我们没有察觉到什么不对劲的。
When our life is a smooth sailing, we have nothing to fear of.
当人生遇到困难的时候
，When we are in troubles,
如果我们找不到帮助
，When we can't find any help,
如果上帝不在我们身边。
When God is not with us,
其实那才是我们真正最恐慌的时候。
That's when we should feel scared.
但这不是上帝给雅各的应许。
But this is not what God has promised Jacob.
他应许雅各总不离弃他。
He's promised Jacob not to leave him.
而上帝当年给雅各的应许，今天也一样给我们这样子的应许。
God has promised us.Today, what he's promised Jacob long, long time ago.
就好像主耶稣说，他会与我们同在，直到世界的末了。
It's the same as what Jesus promised us, that he's going to be with us until the very, very end of the world.
这是主耶稣在升天之前对所有他的门徒说的。
That's what Jesus promised all his disciples before he ascended.
所以第三，我们来看，你走进生命中的伯特利。
Now we're going to look at entering Bethel of our lives.
所以雅各他梦醒了，睡醒了，他说：“耶和华真在这里，我竟不知道。”
When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, "Surely the Lord is in this place, and I wasn't aware of it."
你们觉得雅各他知不知道上帝是谁啊？
Do you think Jacob knew who God was?
知道吗？
Did he know who God was?
你觉得他知道的，请举手一下。
Raise your hand if you think.Jacob knew.
你觉得雅各他不知道上帝是谁的，请举手一下。
If you don't think Jacob knew who God was, raise your hand.
没举手的又是怎样呢？
What about those who didn't raise your hand at all?
就雅各他从小就知道上帝是谁。
Jacob knew all his life who God was.
他一定常常听到父母说上帝怎样怎样带领他们的家。
He'd heard about God from his parents. How Their family had been led by God.
上帝怎样带领他的祖宗，就祖父亚伯拉罕。
How God had led their ancestors, Abraham.
但是这位上帝，也只是他祖父亚伯拉罕的上帝。
And yet, this God was only the God of his ancestor Abraham.
也只是他父亲以撒的神。
It was only the God of his father Isaac.
实际上对他来说，上帝只是他听说的神而已。
In fact, this God was someone he had only heard of.
他所知道的神而已。
A God he knew of.
不过从现在开始。
But from now on.
雅各他人生有一个新的突破。
Jacob was welcoming a new breakthrough of his life.
就是他自己认识上帝了。
Which is to know his God himself.
不再是听说的上帝。
No longer hearing about God.
他真实的经历到上帝。
He was going to really experience God himself.
他真实的遇见上帝。
He was going to encounter God himself.
他的生命跟上帝真正连接起来。
His life was going to start connecting with God.
我不知道大家有没有看 Avatar。
I'm not sure if you watched Avatar.
这电影令我最注意的地方，就是住在那个星球 Pandora 星球里面的人。
What really struck me in this movie is, you know, the people who live in the planet of Pandora.
他们除了很高大以外，他们还留着很长的辫子。
Not only they were all tall, tall and big, but also everyone had long plates.
但是他的鞭子不像王飞鸿的鞭子一样、啊。
But their plates were not like the Kung Fu Master 王飞鸿。
他们的鞭子是有作用的。
It was a great function of their plates.
他们是拿来连接星球任何的生物的。
They used it to connect all the creatures in the planet.
比如他们要骑马，他们就把他们的这个鞭子就连接那个马的须。
For instance, when they're riding a horse, they have to connect the horse's mane with their hair.
然后要跟大树祈祷，他们的鞭子就跟树的柳连接在一起。
And when they pray to the trees, they have to connect their plates with the tree willows.
然后他们就可以感受到那个树的动静。
So they could feel the movement, the heartbeat of the trees.
弟兄姐妹，我们今天跟上帝也是一样。
Brothers and sisters, it's the same for us today.
我们的生命必须跟上帝，我们的主耶稣，他连接起来。
Our lives have to be connected with God.
如果要跟上帝连接，我们就必须亲自遇见上帝。
In order to connect with God, we have to have a personal encounter with Him.
我们要亲自的经历上帝。
We have to experience Him.
这样我们才能够真正的认识上帝。
Only then we can know Him.In our faith.
因为我们的信仰不只是知识上的信仰。
Our faith is not only about, you know, having his knowledge.
我们更需要在感觉上感受他的真实。
We also need to feel him. We have to feel his presence in our lives.
所以我们一定要平衡。
So we have to find a balance.
我们的信仰要有上帝的话为根基。
We need to have God's word as the foundation.
但也要常常经历上帝。
And at the same time, we have to experience him all the time.
我们基督教圈子常会说
You know, in the circle of Christianity,
福音派的教会都是死气沉沉的
Evangelical churches are so boring.
看不到教会的那种活力，那种喜乐
Evangelical churches have no energy, they have no joy.
哇，灵恩派教会就不一样了
On the other hand, the charismatic churches are so different.
哇，但是他们太过热情奔放
But they areover zealous, they're over passionate.
做很多事情好像没有信仰的根基。
A lot of things that they do are like without the foundation of faith.
常常做一些不符合圣经教导的事。
A lot of things that they do are against the Bible teach, the biblical teaching.
那你们会不会好奇啊?
Then, do you ever wonder this?
为什么好像每次被批评的都是灵恩派的教会?
Why are the charismatic churches so often being criticized?
被批评啊，这样做不对，那样做不对。
They have done this wrong, they have done that wrong.
那福音派教会很少的哦。
But why are evangelical churches seldom being criticized?
你们知道为什么吗？
Do you know why?
很简单。
It's simple.
因为福音派教会他们对圣经的知识懂很多。
Even though evangelical churches know a lot about the Christianity teaching,
那很多时候信仰态度冷淡。
A lot of times we are so cold.
聚会死气沉沉。
The gatherings are so boring.
怎样会给人家说做错事呢？
There's no way they could be criticized.
因为什么事都没有做吗？
Because they have done nothing.
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
我们信义会是福音派的。
You know, Lutheran churches belong to evangelical church.
应该说我们是福音派背景的。
We should say, yeah, our background is of evangelical church.
所以我们教会没有说方言，没有医治释放的这种操练。
That's why we don't practice speaking in tongues, prophesying or healing or giving deliverance.
但我们信仰不可以只停留在认识上帝、知道上帝。
But our faith should never ever stop in just our head knowledge.
我们每一天都必须要经历到上帝。
We should experience God every day.
哪怕是小小的事情。
Even if it's just something small.
不管是你在家里。
It could be at home.
你在公司。
In our company.
你去巴萨。
巴萨。
其实我们都可以经历上帝。
Everywhere we are, we can experience God.
我们没有操练医治释放，不代表你不会经历上帝的医治和释放。
Even if we don't practice healing or deliverance, it doesn't mean that we won't experience any healing from God.
我相信我们都看过许多的见证。
I'm sure we've seen and heard many testimonies.
我们也听过不少的道。
And we've heard so many sermons.
那如果我们没有亲身经历上帝、遇见上帝的话
，But if we don't experience Him ourselves,
你知道我们每个礼拜来教会是像什么吗
？You know what is it like coming to church every Sunday?
如果你没有遇见上帝的话，你每个星期来教会只是来看基督信仰的广告而已。
It's just like watching church or Christian advertisement.
今天你在 Facebook 在 Insta 看过很多广告吗
I'm sure you see a lot of advertisements on Facebook, on Instagram.
有几个广告你真的是会去 contact 那个人然后跟他买一些东西询问一些东西的
How many advertisements of those advertisements that you watch, you will really contact the person in charge?
通常看过扫过了扫过了扫过了对吗
Usually you just swipe them through.Don't you?
所以如果你没有经历上帝，你每个礼拜来也是看广告，扫过了。
So it's the same. If we don't experience God ourselves, we just swipe it through, like watching or looking at an advertisement.
每个星期来，你知道哦，上帝与我们同在。
Yes, you come to church every Sunday and you understand that yes, God is with us.
哦，上帝会医治我们的病痛。
Yes, God can heal us.
哦，主耶稣他会行奇妙的事。
Yes, God performs miracles.
然后一到十二点。看完广告过后就没有了。
And at 12 o'clock sharp, that's the end of advertisement.、
哦、也就是这样而已。
That's it.
回家还是老样子。
You go home as the same old you.
每天活到很像死下的。
Yes, you still live a miserable life every day.
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
如果我们信主信到这样的话是很可怜的。
It's pathetic if we live like this.
其实真正的信仰步骤我们是要先遇见上帝
Yes, the very first thing of our true faith is to encounter God
你要经历到上帝你才会慢慢慢慢认识他
Only after experience Him, then we can know Him
不然的话我们跟他连接不起来
Otherwise, there is no way we can connect with God.
如果我们好好看圣经的话
If you look at the Bible properly,
几乎很多的人都是先遇见上帝。
A lot of the people we see in the Bible, they have an encounter with God first.
他们先经历到上帝，然后过后才渐渐认识上帝。
Only after experiencing God themselves, they came to know Him.
亚伯拉罕是这样。
Abraham was like that.
他根本不知道上帝是谁的。
He didn't even know who God was.
摩西也是这样。
The same for Moses.
以赛亚先知也是这样。
The prophet Isaiah was like that too.
彼得是这样。
And it was the same for Peter.
就保罗也是这
样。And Paul.
就像雅各和以赛亚，他们知道上帝是谁的。
Like Jacob and Isaiah, they knew who God was.
保罗他也听过耶稣是谁的。
And Paul.Had also heard of Jesus.
但是唯有他们真正与他上帝相遇的时候，他们才能够真正的知道，哦，这位就是真神。
But it was only after experiencing God that their lives experienced true transformation.
他们的生命才会被改变。
They after encountering God.That their lives were transformed.
所以雅各他真正遇见上帝的时候，他才会惧怕说，这地方何等可畏。这不是别的，乃是神的殿，是天的门。
So only when Jacob really encountered God that he said, How awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven.
他就给那地取名叫伯特利。
And he called that place Bethel.
弟兄姐妹
Brothers and sisters,
我们每个礼拜星期天来到神的殿。
We come to the house of the Lord every Sunday.
其实不单是崇拜或者小组培灵会
It could be worship or cell group or any evangelical meeting
其实任何的聚会最重要的就是我们要遇见上帝
No matter what meeting it is The most important thing is for us to encounter God
这样我们就知道上帝是可敬可畏的神
Only then we know that God is awesome
如果我们今天来到教会，我们没有遇见上帝的话
，If we come to church today without encountering God，
你就会遇见敬拜团
，You will only encounter the worship team。
啊，今天唱的好不好嘞？
Are they good today?
啊，今天有没有弹错嘞？
Oh, did they play any wrong keys today?
啊，牧师讲到很闷嘞。
The pastor is boring today.
啊，报告又打错字了。
Oh, typos in the announcement.
如果人没有遇见上帝，
If you don't encounter God,
大家就像裁判坐在下面这样子。
You are like judges, referees, sitting
down there. 不断的在给每一个东西、每一个人、每一件事在打分数。
You are giving feedback and like score to everyone here.
但是如果你真正遇见上帝的话，
But if you really encounter God,
你知道这里的主角是谁？
You know who the main character is here.
上帝就在我们当中。
God is in our midst.
他就在我们当中看着我们每一个现在敬拜的摆灯是什么。
He's here watching how we worship him.
所以如果你真正敬畏上帝的话，你不会理哎，今天冷气很冷耶，不会啊。
If you're here really worshiping God, really encountering him, you won't complain about the AC.
哎，每次都开这样冷啊，家门不要开这样冷，还整天开这样冷。
Oh, it's always so cold. I've told them so many times, and yet it's always so cold.
哎，没有心情敬拜了。
I have no mood to worship.
然后就看今天带领的人。
And then you look at the leader of the ceremony.
如果你真正敬畏上帝的话，你不会去理这些东西。
If you really fear God, you won't care, you won't be bothered by all the other things.
因为这些都不重要，对你来说。
Because they should be insignificant.
那位荣耀的上帝才是我们唯一的焦点。
The God of glory should be our main focus.
我们信主到现今，我们有遇见上帝吗？
Have we really encountered God throughout our journey of faith?
不管你是第一代的基督徒，还是你是第二代、第三代、第四代的基督徒。
No matter if you are first generation Christian or second generation,
我是否有真的感受过，喂，上帝是真的耶，上帝就在我的身边耶。
Have you really felt the realness of God? Have you really...sensed his presence with you.
我们每一位真的是要有自己的伯特利。
Every Christian should have their own Bethel.
伯特利是帮助我们信仰在动摇的时候能够找到当初与神相遇的那个时刻。
Bethel is something that helps us to remember, to remind ourselves.The very first time we encountered God.
是让你想起当年我怎样经历上帝的大能。
Bethel is something that reminds us how we experienced God's greatness.
我怎样经历耶稣基督对我的拯救。
It reminds us how we experienced God's salvation.
不然的话，你的信仰只是听回来的信仰。
Otherwise, your faith is only something you've heard of.
或者你读回来的信仰
，something you read about，
所以千万要记得。
So please remember，
信仰需要经历上帝。
Your faith needs your first-hand experience。
最后，雅各他遇见上帝过后，他做了一件事情。
Finally, after encountering God, Jacob did something。
雅各清早起来，把所整的石头立作柱子，浇油在上面。
Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it.
古人他们用石柱做立约的记号。
Ancient people made marks on pillar stones to remind themselves.
其实用意是要提醒自己，上帝曾经向他显现。
It is to remind themselves that God had appeared to them.
然后浇油是表示分别为圣的意思。
And the action of burning oil was to show that it was set apart as holy.
如果下一次在面对到任何的问题的时候，经或者经过那里的时候，看到石头就提醒他。
So the next time they experienced any low points in their lives, or the next time they walk past that place, they will be reminded again.
我们要承认，我们人是很容易忘恩的。
I need to confess that we are so easily forgetful.
我们需要一些东西记号来提醒我们记得上帝的作为。
Yes, we need things to remind ourselves.
提醒我们记得上帝的应许。
We need something to remind ourselves, I mean, to remind of God's promises.
提醒我们当年我是如何经历到上帝。
we need something to remind ourselves how God had promised us and how we've experienced God before.
所以上帝是允许我们立记号的。
So yes, God allows us to have symbols.
但为了只是要我们记得他的恩惠和作为。
Just so that we can remember his grace and his deeds.
不是要我们拿这个当偶像来拜，然后插三支香在那边。
He didn't want us to make something like this and have three incense there.
所以基督徒十字架是我们得救的记号。
Yes, the cross is the symbol of our salvation.
每次我们看到十字架就纪念主耶稣如何我们牺牲受苦。
Every time we see the cross, we remember how Jesus has suffered for us.
他怎样为我们成就救恩。
He accomplished his salvation for us.
不是拿来给你当做护身符啦。
It's not for us to be an amulet.
不是拿来辟邪赶鬼啦。
Not something to help us chase away the evil spirits.
他是要你记得上帝的恩惠。
It's just to remind you of God's grace.
所以弟兄姐妹。
So brothers and sisters,
除了十字架以外,
other than the cross,
你的生命中有没有一些经历上帝的记号?
Is there any marks, any symbols that you use to remember God?
当然我们必须要先遇见上帝才有记号可以立啊。
Of course, we have to experience God first before we can have any symbol.
所以总结今天我们学习的。
So,Let's conclude for today.
我们看见雅各他一生都在抓抓抓抓很多东西。
We can see that Jacob was spending his whole life grabbing this, grabbing that.
他就像很多人一样，很想努力，要得到他想得到的事情。
Like a lot of people, he was making great effort to succeed.
也想尽办法得到他要的。
He tried all his can to get what he wanted.
但结果，他什么都没有得到。
In the end, he got nothing.
还要逃命，搞到什么都没有。
And yet, he had to run for his life.
所以在雅各最艰难的时候，上帝介入了他的生命。
So, in his most difficult time, God intervened his life.
当时雅各他没有主动找上帝。
Jacob did not take the initiative to look for God.
他不是哦，很难过，很累了，走到那个旷野那里祷告寻求上帝，他没有。
It wasn't like he was so sad, so hopeless, so helpless that he felt exhausted and he chose to pray to God.
是在雅各他在睡觉的时候，上帝自己来找他。
No, it was God himself who entered his dream. God entered Jacob's life through his dream.
所以在他与上帝相遇过后，他真正认识到这位上帝是真的。
After experiencing him, Jacob felt for the very first time that this God is real.
上帝是可畏的。
Yes, God is awesome.
然后他就为那地取名为伯特利。
That's why he called that place Bethel.
也立下石柱来纪念这是上帝的殿。
And he made a remark with the stone, the pillar stone, to remember God's temple.
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
上帝要在你最艰难的时刻，他要介入你的生命。
Yes, God wants to intervene to your life in your most difficult time.
他要伸手把你从困境中带出来。
He wants to reach out to you.
他要给你一条新的路。
He wants to give you a way out.
你的人生不会在这个时刻结束。
Your life is not going to end here.
这个时刻也不是你的绝路。
This moment is not the end of your life.
上帝要带着祝福把你带进去他的这个祝福里面。
The Lord wants to enter your life with blessings.
因为我们的上帝他不是坐在那个地方等我们的上帝。
Our God is not someone who sits still in the same old place waiting for you.
他没有住在教堂里面呢。
He doesn't live in the church.
他是无所不在在找人的上帝。
He is everywhere. He is looking for people everywhere.
就像爱世人的主耶稣，他一直在寻找世上的人。
Just like our Lord Jesus, who loves us so much, he goes everywhere looking for people.
在寻找在患难中的人。
He looks for the lost.
他今天一样也要带着恩典和祝福来找你。
In the same way, he wants to look for you with grace and blessings.
最重要的是，我们有遇见他吗？
What's most important is whether or not we've encountered him.
要遇见神，我们才能够真正知道他是真的。
Only after encountering God, then we know that he is real.
我们才会活出一个敬畏他的生命。
Only then we can live a life that is in awe of him.
而当我们真正遇见上帝的时候，我们的生命才会被改变。
Only after encountering God, then our life can be transformed.
我们的生命才会有突破。
Our lives can have breakthrough.
我们才会从困境中走进上帝的祝福里面。Amen.
Only then we can walk to his blessings from all the difficulties.
好不好，这个时刻我们也花一点时间。
Now, shall we have a moment of prayer?
如果你从来都没有遇见过上帝的话，
If you've never encountered God before,
求主帮助你今天开始要遇见他。
Let's ask him, seek his help that you may encounter him today.
只要你想要遇见上帝，上帝一定会让你遇见他。
As long as you want to encounter him, God will let it happen.
因为上帝在那里找你很久了。
Because God has been looking for you for so long.
好吧，我们自己安静下来，自己向上帝祷告。
Now shall we quiet ourselves and pray to God?
然后过后我做一个结束的祷告。
And then I'll close in prayer.
我们祷告。
Let's pray.
主，我们感谢你的话语。
Lord, we thank you for your words.
再次的告诉我们，我们真的是要遇见你。
For telling us once again that we need to encounter you.
我们不要在每个礼拜来碰广告。
We don't want to come to see your advertisement every week.
我们不要再是听你的上帝。
We don't want to only hear about you.
我们要真实的遇见你。
We want to experience you.
主，我相信你看见每一个弟兄姐妹他们心中的渴望。
Yes, Lord, I'm sure you can see the deepest desire of the brothers and sisters here.
你也知道我们的顾虑。
You also know our anxieties.
你也知道我们的小心。
You also know our small faith.
但是不管怎样，当年你找雅各，也求你来找上我们每一位。
Lord, please.Find us just like how you found Jacob in the old days.
让我们每个礼拜来到你的殿中，是真的是真实与你相遇的。
So that we have true encounter with you every Sunday.
让我们的生命能够进入到你的丰盛里面。
And that our lives can be transformed in an abundant way.
充满着你的喜乐。
Our lives can be filled of your joy.
充满着你的能力。
Your power,
充满着盼望。
Your hope,
愿你赐福每一位弟兄姐妹。
Bless every one of us here.
我们祷告，奉主耶稣基督的名。
We pray all this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.